Welcome, welcome, welcome. We have on this stage of the weekend an array of music from bands and solo artists. We have Morris Teens, which will be emceed by Steve Ewicker. We have children's workshops. We have a procession finale on the Sunday. We have circus stunts. We have bedtime storytelling. I can't even say it. We have puppetry. It's fantastic. This is the stage to be on. You know it as. Forget the big stage. Just come here. It's the village stage. It's where it's going to happen. Without further ado, I'd like to introduce you now to our first band for Shrewsbury Folk Festival. The Shrewsbury International Folk Festival, it should be called. This is a local girl from Ludlow called Penny Priest. Ludlow is, for those of you who don't know, Shropshire is just kind of down the road, about 30 miles, South Shropshire. She first played at the Folk Festival in 2006. They have just finished recording their first LP, where I recorded my first LP, in a place called Lane's End Studio in Cleehill. And we both agreed it's very, very damp. So go and buy the LP and see what it sounds like. The band is Penny Priest, backing guitar, vocals, violin and keyboard. Martin Thomas, lead guitar, Spanish guitar, slide, mandolin, harmonica and vocals. Mike Ridley Dash, I like that, sounds good. Double electric bass. James Raybould on the drums. They'll be playing at the Sabrina Marquee later on. And Penny has described her music as music to unfold to, which is fantastic. I will leave you with a quote from Othello. An admirable musician, oh, she will sing the savageness out of a bear. Ladies and gentlemen, Penny Priest. Thank you.
Hello, Shrewsbury. It's a real honour to be opening the festival this year. I'm really pleased about that. Okay, our first song is called What Wolves Do. The world
Especially for Brendan, who is not with us in person, but he says he's here in spirit, so I'm sure he's around here somewhere.
Is Brishtia Motri, is Oinach Molin, Smo Storin Nidhi, Smeg.
fabulous start to the afternoon. They will be signing CDs.
How are you getting on? Good. It's lovely to be here. This is my first time ever in Shrewsbury, so I'm delighted to be here. And I'm glad that the rain has stopped and the sun's back out again. I have a fantastic band with me today. Over here on guitar is Mr. Boo Hewitt, all the way from Cambridge. And all the way on the end is Mr. Chris Drever, all the way from Orkney. And he's just back from a world tour with Mark Knopfler, Mr. John McCusker.
Thank you.
so much.
Outside of our living room, over the Manhattan sky, like you saw last night. I don't understand where she's gone. When the morning comes, I promise you she'll be back tonight. Find her and say goodnight. So you look for her in the books we read, and the shadows curve your shoulder to me. And the sun goes down and she's there again, brighter now. You bring new friend in for me. Skylines change, same old buildings rearrange. The skies are rich in shade of blue, and the moon's my new friend too. I used to draw on a straight line. Now I'm walking on a road that winds. We take my hand, we take our time. We take our time, take our time. Moon shines on our half of the sky. Don't have you left behind. It's nighttime here, it's morning there, but the moon's the same everywhere. While I'm singing you a lullaby, someone's waking up on the other side. The moon's shining on her too. She'll see it and she'll think of you. She'll think of you. I used to travel in a straight line. Now road of wine, you take my hand, we take our time, we take our time, take our time. You hear music in everything, the rains are drawn, the traffic swings. Listen to you and I dance along, keep on dancing. The music's gone. Take our time, take our time. I used to travel in a straight line. Now I'm walking on a road that winds. You take my hand, we take our time. Take our time. Oh, we take our time.
To visit in Manhattan with my highfalutin kin, send off to the catalog to get some clothes. Felt so stylish from my head to my toes. Seen all the sights and I even done some flirting. I was doing alright till my feet started hurting. Then I kicked off my shoes. This should be sung by a woman, by the way. And I thought they couldn't see, but they must have, 'cause this is what they all said to me. Put your shoes on, Lucy, don't you know you're in the city? Put your shoes on, Lucy, it really is a pity. Lucy can't go barefoot wherever she goes, 'cause she loves to feel the wheel of her toes. Put your shoes on, Lucy, 'cause you're here in Old New York. You'll get by alrighty if you let your knee talk. All the city slickers love your southern drawl, so give them that honey child and howdy all. Lucy, let the good things happen to you, Lucy. Won't you quit that gapping? How you act will be the death of me. Don't they have skyscrapers down in Tennessee? Put your shoes on, Lucy, even though they kind of pinch. Stop that balking, you gotta do some walking. talking, it's a cinch. Use your party manners, you need them in hand. Put your shoes on, Lucy, you're a big girl now. Put your shoes on, Lucy, cause you're hearing only your. You get by righty if you let them hear you talk. All the city slickers love that southern drawl, so give them that honey child and howdy all. Lucy, let the good things happen to you, Lucy. Won't you quit that gambling? How you act will be the death of me. Don't they have skyscrapers down in Tennessee? Put your shoes on, Lucy, in the kind of pinch. Stop that barking, you're gonna do some walking, it's a cinch. Use your party manners, you need them and how. Put your shoes on, Lucy, you're a big girl now. Put your shoes on, Lucy, you're a big girl now. Thank you.
Mr. Andy Wall, ladies and gentlemen, superb. Still sweet.
cannot rise like that shine comes from thine eyes. The day breaks not, it is my heart become. Darkness, darkness, bind him to me. Hide him in your velvet cloak. Come the dawn, he'll rise and go. I'm marching to the
upon a time, quite a long way away from here, a carter by the name of Jack, and every day he drove the long road from Abergavenny to the Forest of Dean. Along that road there's a nasty kink and a nasty steep hill, but there's a lovely little cottage there, and there's a lady who lived there, and her name was Granny Smith. Now, she lived on her own in her little cottage, and down by the side of the fireplace there was her cat. He was a lovely old cat, quite big, quite podgy, but much loved, like an old teddy bear. Well, it was that Jack used to call in every day, and he used to have a cup of tea, and he used to have a little biscuit. Except this one day he called in, and Granny said, "What's the matter, Jack? You look very agitated." He said, "Agitated, agitated. You wouldn't believe what I've just seen. It's incredible. I was coming along, it was really dark this morning when I set off. In fact, it was pitch black. And as I came along past the cemetery, I heard the strangest thing. I heard a chanting and a ranting and a going on the other side of the wall." He said, "Do you know what? I climbed up on the back of the car and I peeked over the wall and there was a funeral going on. Only, yeah, you'll have to understand this, it wasn't people. It were cats. There were cat mourners. And there were cat pallbearers, and they were carrying a little coffin, and they were all chanting the same thing. Old Tom Tether is dead. Old Tom Tether is dead. Old Tom Tether is dead." Jack stood there, and he's waiting for a reaction from the old woman. She wasn't looking at him at all. She was looking right past him, to by the side of the fire, where her old cat had reared up onto his hind legs, and he stood there and he bristled out until he was nearly twice his normal size, and he pushed out his chest and he went. Jack looked down at the cat and he was amazed. He said, "That cat's never done that." And before he could speak, the cat went, "If old Tom Tether is dead, then I'm the king of the cats." And with that, he shut up the chimney and was never seen again. But for the next few days, poor old Granny, she fretted. She couldn't think about what on earth she was going to do without her cat. She wanted him back. So she started searching. She put little posters up. She went everywhere. She asked at every farmhouse for miles around. Nobody had seen her cat. Eventually, after a long shot, about a month had passed. There was a far outlying farm. She sort of vaguely didn't like the woman who lived there, but she thought she'd give it a go anyway. So she went up and she said, "I wonder, have you seen my cat? He's a sort of gingery thing. He's a bit threadbare and his ears a bit funny and he's about this long and this big and he's got a funny tail." I said, "Oh, that old thing, he used to come around here a lot. In fact, he had a wife amongst my cats." "Really? No." "Yeah, they had a kitten. Just about a couple of years ago now." "Could I see it?" "Yes, of course you can. Hang on a minute." Threw a bit of cat food out. Next minute, cats come from everywhere, all over the farm. That's him. That's someone there. Ginger cat. She picked him up. Oh, he was beautiful. He was the spitting image of her old cat when he'd been about that age. And she said, can I have him? I'll buy him from you. I'll give you gold. Oh, she said, we've got lots of cats. You take that one and have it for your own. So she put the cat in the basket and she went home. And the following morning, she went down to the bank and she said to the bank man, I want all my gold in a bag. And the bank manager said, that's your life savings. Yes, she said, I want it, all of it in a bag. So he gave her all the gold in a bag with two security officers to look after her. They went down the high street. And first they went to the silversmiths and they ordered a silver bowl. Great big solid silver bowl. Then they went to the goldsmiths and they ordered an even bigger gold bowl. And then they went to the carpenters and they ordered a little tiny four-poster bed, about that big by that big by that high, with cloth of gold curtains and a little coverlet and even a duvet, everything. And then to the jewellers for a diamond encrusted collar and a little crown. All that day the delivery men were arriving. All that day she waited and collected all the parcels and then she opened them. And the following morning Jack the Carter came round to have his cup of tea. And he went in and there in the corner is the most incredible thing. There's a four-poster bed, but it's only this big. There's a huge silver bowl. There's a huge gold bowl with cat food in it. The silver bowl has got buttermilk. And the cat himself sat there with a diamond collar on and with a little crown on the top of his head. And Jack said, what's all this? You've spent every penny that you've got, every single penny of all your gold. Why have you done this? She said, well, my old cat used to sit down there and eat off cracked saucers. He used to sleep on an old pillow. But you know, I know something now about this cat that I never knew about my old cat. I've said goodbye to my old cat. He was the king of the cats. But this is the heir to the king of the cats. Thank you for listening.
Of you, won't you sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves. I'm breezing along, along with the breeze. I'm hearing a song through the trees. Ooh, that pine melody caressing the shore, familiar to me, I've heard it before. Yeah, I know it's the Southland, and don't I feel it in my soul, and don't I know that I have reached my goal. Won't you sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves.
Crosses high above the cold Missouri water. Spins, make you a little weak in the shins. Well, here's to the one whose sorry head hangs over the rim of the Armitage Shanks. Sometimes they'll tell you it's just for customers' use. You ask real nice, but they still refuse. You'd give all the money that you have in the bank if they'd only let you use the Armitage Shanks. Armitage Shanks, Armitage Shanks. Let us be grateful, let us give thanks. May we never regret the drinks we drank. Praise be the name of Armitage Shanks. This is the last song before the break. You can't sit still and your kidneys ache. Just a wee bit longer while I fill in some blanks. You'll appreciate it even more, the Armitage Shanks. Now as you sit there listening to me, you've been drinking pints and y'all have to pee. Wouldn't it be a pretty good prank. You'd have 65 verses to Armitage Shanks. 65 verses to Armitage Shanks. 65 different ways that we could give thanks. But I know for you that there's only one. Gonna end this song soon, and y'all can run. But meanwhile, don't think of rivers, don't think of creeks. Chase away thoughts about pipes that leak, faucets dripping, and balloons gone bang. Till after you've been to the Armitage Shanks, Armitage Shanks, Armitage Shanks. Let us be grateful, let us give thanks. May we never regret drinks we drank. Praise be the name of Armitage Shanks. You know how to spell Mississippi? M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P. Hi. Yeah, that's how you spell Mississippi. M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. Armitage Shanks, sing it with me. Armitage Shanks. Let us be grateful. Let us give thanks. May we never regret the drinks we drank. Praise be the name of Armitage Shanks. That wasn't everybody. Armitage Shanks, Armitage Shanks. Let us be grateful, let us give thanks. May we never regret the drinks we drank. Praise be the name of Armitage Shanks. You were just moving your lips. Armitage Shanks, Armitage Shanks. Let us be grateful, let us give thanks. May we never regret the drinks we drank. Praise be the name of Armitage Shanks. Yeah, that's how you spell Mississippi. Thanks, everybody. See you again.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chuck Brodsky.
I believe that day.